It's my pleasure to welcome Kelly Bissell from Accenture and Vasuja Kaul from Microsoft to discuss why security and privacy matter for all modern organizations. Now, Kelly, you work with organizations to better understand the need for a comprehensive approach towards security. Why has this topic grown so important today?
That's right. I think all companies need to take a comprehensive view, even more today than ever before, because I think the risks are greater and our ability to innovate is outstripping our ability to secure it. So this is really important, and I'm delighted to spend some time with Vasu with me. And so if I could ask Vasu, what are you seeing in the market? And what do you think are some of the takeaways that we should talk through today?
Well, hello, Kelly. It's great to be here with you and Mariana to discuss this critical topic. So to start with, I just want to say it's hard out there for defenders right now. When you look at what's happening in our world, the increased sophistication and complexity of cyber attacks, meeting the exponential increase in digital attack surfaces, and then you have geopolitical tensions as well as talent shortage. But it's also a really inspiring time to be in security because security matters. It is quintessential to who we are as human beings, and it's a fundamental human need. So there are some key takeaways for me as we look at security and how do we protect our world, our organizations, and our people. First, we need a comprehensive security posture. We need to look at it end-to-end, across key pillars of cybersecurity, compliance, identity, and management as an interdependent whole. We have to protect and extend this across all clouds and all platforms. We know that attacks can come from anywhere, so we need to look at it outside in and inside out. The second takeaway, Kelly, for me, is about security being a team sport. This is a village. It takes a village. We're not in this alone. And we have to work together. We have to meet our customers where they are at. We have to understand their needs deeply, and we have to protect them on their terms. And lastly, related to that, great partnerships matter. For us to work together and for us to protect and increase our collective defenses, we need to match our superpowers. And that's why I'm excited about working with you and Accenture. We have a great partnership where we bring our own unique superpowers. After all, we are all unique in our own ways. And we're forming Justice Leagues or Avengers or pick your, you know, favorite superhero. So I'll sum it up by saying, I'm so proud to be a defender. I'm so proud to be in security. It really matters. And let's empower everyone to use security for innovations so that everyone can bring their best lives and live their best lives.
Vasu, I love that, to be Avengers and superpowers, if you will. And I agree that we have to actually do this together. If we're going to make a dent, we've got to go together. And maybe one of the other takeaways for me is the importance of zero trust for security. You know, we've had this thing about, least privilege for more than 15 years back from the Sarbanes-Oxley day, but that was really focused on access controls. Zero trust, as our organizations have talked about it, is around all elements of security, not just the access controls. So we can interrogate, does the user or even machine have the right in this context to access this information? And how do we ensure that we're safe across the board? So I love that we can pull that together in things like access control, multi-factor authentication, encryption, and all kinds of other security elements. So as companies, I think that we have to really ensure that we move forward with this continuous zero trust model so that we can really ensure the safety inside of our organizations, not just the outside.
Yeah, I love that, Kelly. And it's interesting that security is about trust, and trust starts with zero trust, right? It's ironical. And many customers ask, like, you know, where should we start the zero trust journey? Because it's unique to every organization, and every single step strengthens our security posture. So as I think of zero trust, there are a couple of things which come to mind. First is start with a strong cloud identity. You talked about it, access really matters at making sure that we are protected against what's coming in. We have strong authentications. We have strong multi-factor authentication, conditional access, and so. Second, make sure your devices are healthy. Management matters. Patch. Third, you have to embrace the cloud. The cloud gives you so much leverage with all these built-in defenses, bringing together the best of what defenders have been doing and simplifying your Assume breach toolset to bring that extended detection and response coupled with SIEM. And then lastly, don't forget about compliance. Data, 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 that matters. What's happening inside your organization? How is data leaking? What's happening with insider risk? So think about those four pillars as you think about a zero trust posture.
That's right. And so I think that now we could think about zero trust and we think about through the lens of this increased attack with nation state attacks and other things. Now we got to think about how do we rethink? How do we transform the way we think about security? And I believe it starts with the board. So as Henry Kissinger would say, I don't have time for a crisis. My schedule is full. And I think that's true. But I think that we got to really think differently about this. And so as we look at the board where they have directors, I think they got to reflect the company around, you know, if you're a pharma company, around joint ventures and labs and clinical trials and manufacturing and distribution, but also cyber, because regulation is changing all the time. The threats are changing every day. And I think that we need to really think about in our companies, not only zero trust within what we have today, but how are we moving in the future of innovation like AI and quantum, and how do we not only embed security and privacy into that, but how do we recover if something doesn't work? So I think we got to really think differently about our innovation, about how we think about through from order to cash processes, if you will. We have to think about third-party risk and suppliers, and how we think about zero trust across the board for all of that.
Yeah, I love that, Kelly, and I love where you started with preparation, because preparation really matters. You have to prepare, you have to be ready, and you have to prevent, detect, response across the board. And one of the things as you think of preparation is not only being current on where the threat landscape is, where your response and your playbooks need to be, but also preparing yourself with skills. And we heard from Mariana that skilling is a top thing that our communities are thinking about right now. So we can start our skilling journeys anyway. It requires a growth mindset. It requires us to learn new things, and it's exciting. And with that, I'm super excited that Microsoft launched 4 new skilling certifications across security, compliance, identity, as well as management to tackle some of the talent shortages that we're seeing. It's like 3.5 million jobs right now, but also to help people learn more about security. It's fun stuff, and I'm really excited we are doing that. So check out our resource page. Also check out this pretty robust technical resource library that we have. And if you need anything more, and if you want to learn, shoot us a note. And with that, Kelly, I would love to again pass this back to you to hear from your standpoint about skilling and what else is top of mind for you.
All right, well, that's really important. And I think that we have to double down on the skills of not just computer science people, but industry people that know how banks work or pharma companies or oil and gas. And then track the data and who has access to it and a responsibility to our customers so that we can create trust and resilience. So, Fasu, look, I'm very thankful for Microsoft's stance on security and privacy. So together, as superheroes, as the Avengers, if you will, that we can make the world a safer place and that we can all thrive. So Vasu, thank you for spending some time with me on this subject. And back to you, Mariana.
Well, we all definitely feel safer knowing that the Avengers are out there keeping us safe from the cybersecurity threats. And one of the takeaways from me actually was that security, it's not just about protection, but it is an investment that helps enable growth and innovation for organizations. So earlier during this conversation, we posted a poll to hear from our audience. The results are coming in. Everyone's talking about this hot topic, as I mentioned. So we're going to start taking one of the first questions. And let's see, it's coming in. I'm going to ask one of each of you. And this first one is coming in for Vasu. How do you see the role of enterprise board of directors evolving in light of increasing cyber risk?
Yeah, great question. Thank you so much. So if you look at the role, the board of directors plays a really critical role in cybersecurity and has evolved tremendously over the last few years. board, cybersecurity is a topic which is critical from the boardroom to the back room. And that's because cybersecurity matters not just in terms of economic impact, but it matters in terms of reputation and brand and safety and growth and all of that. So the board of directors right now plays a pretty critical role in asking great questions around governance. What is the cybersecurity posture of an organization? What are we doing to strengthen our defenses? How are we tackling? What's the best way to measure security across the board? And I do think that with great governance and with the board asking these great questions and playing a critical role in innovation for the company, we can all build a better organization and better growth.
Thank you, Vazu. Kelly, and now people want to know what your opinion on this issue is. So let me re-ask the question. How do you see the role of enterprise board of directors evolving in light of the increasing cybersecurity risk?
That's right. I agree with Vazu. I think she's absolutely right. But, you know, boards don't take a management position, but they need to actually understand the issues of today and where they're going and all the regulations associated with that company, so they can actually hold management accountable. That's their job. And I think that the more that they know, the better. And so they can drill into the very specific questions around, have they implemented zero trust? How do they know it's working? How do they know that they're not only their corporate offices is safe, but what about their OT environment or their plants? How do they ensure that their subs and affiliates are safe? And what about those third parties that really they rely on their ecosystem? So I think the board's role is something that they need to dig in deeper around the cybersecurity and privacy topic.
Thank you both. Unfortunately, we're out of time, but what an enriching discussion. I'm sure Kissinger would have wanted both of you on his crisis team. Thank you. And to learn more about the topics discussed here today, we are going to check out some of the featured resources posted in the chat and on the Envision website where you're watching now.